on your screen, and like you know, you can reach us on *173 and don't touch that dial. We have so much to talk about this morning as it concerns the National Sports Festival right there in Abuja. There are issues of poaching, there are issues of teams complaining about welfare. As the case may be, our preparation for the game was met with so much uphill and timing. We'll look at that this morning. We'll also look at what the Super Falcons will go through in their World Cup draws, not forgetting also the Beach Eagles are right there in Egypt doing it the way they know how to do it. And we'll go to Europe and look at some of the league, the top leagues, as games were played. The biggest talking point in football for this weekend was the game between Man City and Chelsea, and you just had Vera celebrating that victory. Why? I can't tell you. But it was a very big one. My name is Tiremem Princewill of VSN. They call me the Duke. And with me is my paddy, Olakule Phillips. Kule, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Princewill. It's good to be back on the show. And the weekend was full of exciting, thrilling games. And then we talk about that Chelsea versus Manchester City game. I remember Dortmund. And one other person were predicting that Chelsea were going to... And Olambi, they actually predicted that Chelsea were going to be beating, they were going to get the pacing of their life. But what we saw was a different ballgame mentality. And just like you said, you can't go on beating for how many games. Yeah. And that has come. And it's also go the way of Liverpool, because Liverpool are also yet to lose a game in the campaign so far.
Well, we'll get there in this segment as we look at those other issues. But let's start from the home front, where the National Sports Festival has kick-started right there in Abuja last week, Thursday to be very precise. And a lot of issues are coming up. The standing of the table as of 6:26 p.m. yesterday is known. Delta State is leading. Bokule, let's look at the games critically. The objective of the National Sports Festival is to discover talent. From the reports coming in, a lot of states are complaining of poaching, especially Abuja and the rest of others.
Yes, a lot of coaches are complaining, and you know, even the play, the athletes who are participating are also complaining. But I think this is expected. I actually thought that probably before the start of the competition, a lot of things will be put in place. And just like the organizer, the LOC chairman said, they said they're going to get things done before, I mean, a day to the competition. But we didn't see this at all, because even right from the opening ceremony, there were a lot of things that went wrong in that game, in the start. The time, the kickoff was supposed to, was supposed to take center stage for 4:30, but people had to wait till around 6, and some people were even angry and they left. They had to leave the Abuja National Stadium before eventually it all kick-started. And I think we are not surprised, principally, because the preparation was shoddy. And at a point in time, it wasn't looking as if we're going to have the National Sport Festival. If one really has to give kudos to the Minister for Sports for actually taking his stand and ensuring that the National Sport Festival started. And it's just sad at the way things are at the moment.
Yes, sad. That's where I was going to, because it's on report that there's a particular state, the Wolves, they're passing through, is unprecedented. I'm particularly concerned about the Ogun State contingent to the National Sports Festival. First, they had a road accident, they had fire accident, robber attack. And if you look at some of the states, their complaint is inadequate preparation. If we're not ready, why did we actually go on with the game?
Yes, I think this is not. I think before now, we've been hearing about the last time the National Sports Festival went was held, dated back to 2012.
Yes, in Lagos.
Yeah. And all the states that promised to actually, host, were pulling out. Remember, the last one was even River State who pulled out. And the minister just felt it has to restart it. And that's exactly what they have done. The minister said on Thursday that the reason why the states are not, they are not taking their stand to host the tournament, the competition, is as a result of misappropriation. There was a way he put it, that the states are not saying, they are not making it a priority. And this leaves much to be desired.
Let me come in here, Kule. We're talking about
Misplacement of priority. That was the way he actually tagged it.
That's the minister's point of view.
Yes.
But we're talking about preparation, international championship, and we've seen the sudden nosediving of our athletes when it comes to competing out there. And the only avenue to discover new athletes does not have a proper propagating stance. Where are we going from here?
It's sad, Prince. It's disheartening. It leaves much to be desired, because this is what we call our own festival, the National Sport Festival, where talents are supposed to be discovered. And this is, you know, we spoke about at the point is that we talked about the development of so many sports in the country. Apart from football, other sports have actually been suffering. We spoke about table tennis back in the days of Atoda Musa. You have the ball, the table, all over the country in different streets. But now, what do we have? We don't have the balls around, and there's no developmental program for all of these sports. And it's just so sad and disheartening that the way only Delta State seems to be ready. And the governor has been talking tough. He promised the athletes, just win a gold medal,
you
get a million naira. Silver medal, you get 500. You get a bronze, you get 250. Kudos to Governor for all of this.
Let me come back, Patrick, so that I don't look sarcastic. if you go to the table, Delta State has 34 gold, 17 silver, and 12 bronze, with a total of 53 medals. They're topping.
Yeah.
The first top four is Delta, in this order, Delta, Lagos, Bayelsa, and Akwa Ibom. Kule, the question now is poaching. Some states are complaining that other states are poaching their athletes.
I think it's all still boils down to lack of preparation on the part of the states. I think there were no preparation, proper preparation. And if you ask some of the state governors and the commissioners, they will tell you that probably they were not well informed. There were no assurance that the National Sport Festival
for 6 years
was going to hold.
But
you know, we've been having disappointments the part of the states.
From every retrospective, sports development should be a continuum. You shouldn't wait for a particular festival to come up before you do that.
Yeah, I think that's one of the things the sport minister is saying, and it's sad. I think everybody should come together.
Delta State and Lagos State that are topping the table right now, you want to tell me they had it in anticipation that they'll be at the National Sports Festival?
They didn't have it, but I think we really have to give kudos to the governors in charge of those states and those that surrounds the governor, those are in charge of sports that the governor has actually put in the sporting department, doing a very, very good job. I think on the part of those other countries, those other states that are not doing well, we really have to put blame on those in charge of sports in those states.
All right, at the National Sports Festival, the following states have not won any medal. You're talking about Cross River. I am disappointed. Cross River of all states.
Yes.
They were supposed to host the National Sports Festival, and they said they didn't have sufficient money. We have Cross River, Ebonyi, Jigawa, Kebbi, Nasarawa, Ondo, Yobe, Zamfara. These are the states that have not won any medal.
It's just so sad.
We're going to talk about these games more in subsequent edition of Super Zone Sports. But from your perspective, what do you want to see at the end of the game?
Yeah, we want to see things really take shape, because a lot of things are not still wrong. Facilities-wise, there's still been, some of the facilities are not up to standard according to the failures we're getting from there. And we said, the LOC chairman said they were going to get things done before the start of the competition.
That was near impossible.
Yes, it was impossible. But the good thing is that the National Sports Festival has kick-started, and we want to see talents discovered. Someone said, I think I heard there's a news about a young lady about 6 years of age who participated in chess and actually won a bronze medal. This is really good. This is what we are looking for. We want to see more talents being discovered, those kind of talents that will be able to do well in subsequent years. Yes, and represent always the flag of the country very high.
All right. That's for the National Sports Festival, and you can be rest assured that events are ongoing right now, right there in Abuja. And Phila's coming in is that the crowd is not encouraging. They're not seeing the crowd. And some of the sports administrators have complained about the conditions of facilities, especially when it comes to provision of necessary amenities to the athletes. We'll bring you more reports in subsequent edition of Superdome Sports, like I said earlier on. Let's move on and look at something quite great. Kunle, when I saw that draw, the Super Falcons draw, they'll be meeting France, Norway, and Korea Republic. I just felt like, what was the need of going to the World Cup? yes, that was the truth. What was the need?
There's a saying that you go to us, if you want to beat the best, you have to beat the best. And I don't know how this is going to happen. And someone said, there's need for us to have a very, very adequate and proper preparation before the start of the World Cup. It starts
we have
on
six
June,
months.
Yeah, July 7 and it yeah. ends, and June 7 ends on July 7. We need to prepare very well. Mm-hmm. And who says we cannot beat all these teams?
I'm I am not saying it's not possible. But our preparatory state, we saw what happened in Ghana.
Yes.
Thomas Dennerby was brought in to create a change.
Yes.
That change we've not seen. Yeah. Now we have 6 months. Can we really, you know, the last time the Super Falcons got out of their group was 1999.
Yes.
After that time, we've not seen any marvelous performance.
Yes.
Can we replicate 1999?
Yes, Mr. One good thing about the fixtures is the fact that the first game we're going to be playing on June 8th against Norway. I think Norway are top force to reckon with when it comes to women football.
And don't forget that France also spanked us 7-0.
Let's not go there.
I must go
there. We're going to be playing against France in our last game.
Yes.
So that gives us probably, if we're able to get favorable results against Norway and Korea, then probably the game
probably. I like that one, Jerry.
Well, there's need for us to have an adequate preparation. Mercy Akide, the Super Falcons International, spoke about the fact that adequate preparation is needed. And I remember when I met this woman.
Yes, let me come. Sorry, I need to come in here. Talking about adequate preparation, we are depending on the foreign pros. And we have young girls. Look at what Rashidat Ajibade did in Ghana. For me, I think Thomas should look inward and add some few foreign pros.
Someone said some of the players that participated in the recently concluded African Women Cup of Nations were picked by coaches. It wasn't Dennerby that actually picked them because for now, I think he doesn't really know much about some of those girls.
Part of the criterion for his job, Kule, is to go around the pitches and work with the coaches.
Yes, if he doesn't, for me, what he has achieved so far is something so many of our coaches have achieved. So
Paul
it's
Hamilton,
not a guru.
Ismael Amabu.
Yes, Florence Omagbemi.
Thank you.
All of them have actually been able to achieve all of this. He needs to do something exceptional. He needs to do the reason why he was appointed to be the coach of the Super Falcons is to take the Super. We've conquered Africa.
Let's conquer the world.
And that's,
well,
Be
real, is it possible? Well, let's go on. Let's look at another team that is doing exceedingly well right there in Egypt. Is the Bish Eagles. They had their first game against Senegal. The game ended 4-4, but they lost on penalty. And they defeated
Libya,
and they were meeting Tanzania. I think it was a tricky one with the Senegalese.
Yeah, the Senegalese are the defending champions. It's been a big tussle between Nigeria and Senegal and probably Egypt when it comes to beach football on the African continent. And right now, the Senegalese looks like the best in Africa as we speak. As far as
they were lucky, don't you think so?
Yeah, they were lucky in this one.
Yes.
Yeah, the last time I think they won in Nigeria.
Yeah.
The 2016 edition. And right now, the good thing is that after losing that game, the game ended in a 4-4 draw, and after extra time and all of that, and they won via penalty shootout, 2-0 against the Libyans. We took them to the cleaners.
And the Libyans won their first game.
Yeah, they won their first game against Tanzania.
Yeah.
The Tanzanians are making their debut appearance at the beach,
exactly,
at African Cup of Nations, and they got the baptism of fire against the Libyans. That, right now, against the Libyans, the good thing is that we brought our campaign back into reckoning with that convincing victory. And against debutant Tanzania today, 1:30 p.m. Nigerian time, I think they will get a real pasting of their lives.
Kule is speaking like the coach that he thinks he wants to be. Well, we wish the Beach Eagles the very best right there in Cairo. We know that they can do it. Just go out there and do it. Up Eagles. Quickly, let's move into Europe and see some of the games. But the big talking point was a game that was played on Saturday and everybody went gaga, especially the pundits for pool staking. A lot of them lost their bet. Kule, people never saw this coming.
I'm sure some of our guys, Sukomi also.
Yes. Tickets born.
Tickets scatter.
Tickets scatter. Nobody saw this coming. But we know at a point in time, Man City will eventually lose.
Yeah.
But not at this earlier period, especially moving towards Christmas.
And losing against the Chelsea team, whose campaign
has
been questionable in the last four games. They've actually not been convincing.
On Twitter.
Lost against even Wolves.
Yes,
Hampton Wanderers.
On Twitter, the Chelsea players were called dogs. Now they're not heroes. You can imagine.
And you know, that's the beauty of the round leather game. And never say that. You cannot actually say a team will lose, a smaller team compared to a big team. That's why you even see some of those teams, Wolverhampton Wanderers, Huddersfield. Arsenal had to struggle against Huddersfield before they could notch up that
Torreira
win against Torreira.
Torreira. I prefer Torreira.
All right, yeah. A good win for Chelsea. No one saw it coming. All the pundits, everyone predicted
Man City
were going to massacre Chelsea. But Chelsea,
let me ask you at this junction.
Why they are still Chelsea?
Let me ask you at this junction. Right. This defeat, what impact will it have on Man City? Because moving towards Christmas, there are so many games to play, the EPL Cup, the FA Cup, the Champions League, and the EPL. I think
it's just a wake-up call for Manchester City. No one is invisible when it comes to football. Mm. And they can't go unbeaten in almost 38 games.
Do you see them losing another game again?
They might lose, but I still see them winning the EPL.
Obviously.
Liverpool are top right now, but you know the factor. The Liverpool, subsequently, when you expect them to live up to billing, they tend to falter. And I see this happening in this season as well.
They become Folake.
They are going to lose games, and I still see Manchester City. Manchester City will bounce back from this loss, and in their subsequent games, they begin to win. Liverpool, for me, will still not win the EPL.
Let me take you on the Arsenal issue, because I know you're a strong ardent supporter of this particular team. Suddenly, there's a rejuvenation in the Arsenal team. What is Emery doing right? And the Torreira factor is also playing a key role.
Yes, I think Coach Maurizio Emery actually looked at what has been the problem Arsenal has faced in the last three seasons. I looked at players with the money available, looked for the best players for the prizes, and he went for them, and he was able to secure their services. I said it before now, we've been saying it over and over again, it was time for Arsene Wenger to go and rest. You know, there are times that you begin to get things wrong.
When the ovation is loud, you take a bow.
You take a bow. And he didn't do that until
that Arsene Wenger might have had a Nigerian advising him? You know, back here,
we'll
stay put. Okay, let's quickly go to La Liga. And something spectacular did happen over the weekend. Lionel Messi scored two fabulous free kicks. But that's not the issue. The stat is that in the last 13 years, he has been scoring the double-double in every season. Those free kicks. Everybody keeps seeing the reason to take dead balls outside the 18-yard box now.
Yes, two coming in a game that was simply sumptuous, simply fantastic, simply delirious. I think I would love to watch
you're
free kicks
over and over again. You're making me hungry. Sumptuous.
Really, really very fantastic. If you look at those free kicks, the manner in which he took them, you really want to take, you want to watch those penalties, those free kicks over and over again. Good one against, it was a derby against Espanyol. And you know, anytime, that game could have gone either side. Just by the pedigree of Barcelona, Espanyol could have given them a shocker. But there was no shocker in that one. Mm. Lionel Messi was on rampage, and he got those fantastic free kicks.
All right, that's all we can take on this segment. But quickly, a brief one. Lionel Messi bought a jet, and guess what? His name, the wife, and the three kids' name are right there on the jet. That is something to engrave the family forever. I am still Prince Olivisa signing out. Kule, thanks for coming in this morning.
Yeah, my pleasure.
And I'm very sure that at 3 p.m. this afternoon, SportsBeat will be on. The things we can treat so well on Sport on Sports are usually on SportsBeat. So stay tuned to Super Screen Television 173 Star Time. We'll go on this break, but we'll come back. Vera will be running up the Sport on Magazine Show.